Hello, I'm Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. And what a fantastic day it is so far. 28th of March and 21 degrees centigrade. Unheard of in the UK for several years, so I'm out making the most of it. In this video, I want to introduce you to taking better flower pictures. You might think that being outside in bright sunshine gives you the best opportunity to take flower pictures. But unfortunately, that's not always the case. Some blooms tend to lend themselves to direct sunshine, where others have more subtle shades and you need to use a more diffuse light source. So in this video I want to show you a couple of techniques which will improve your flower photography. One of them is by using a circular polarizing filter, which allows you to screen out some of the reflections from leaves and petals so you don't get these hot spots which tends to detract from the flower picture. Another one is to use a diffuser. Now this is just a portable reflector made of nylon material, but I don't use it to reflect light back into the picture. I use this as a diffuser. So I point this towards the sun and the area behind is now in diffuse light. So it's not actually in shade, you're using this actual area of the white nylon to act as a larger light source so you don't get the pinpoint light effect of direct sunshine. And it gives you some nice soft diffuse lighting. You might need to post-process your images if you use this technique to actually add back a little bit of contrast. But apart from that, this diffuser gives you some really nice pictures. So we'll set about taking a few shots and I can show you the difference with and without the diffuser and with or without the polarizing filter. For this shoot I'm going to be using the Panasonic Lumix FZ150, which has the advantage of being a small sensor camera, gives me tremendous depth of field. Because I want sharpness from front to back of the image, I would need to use something like an f16 or f22 if I was using a larger format sensor camera like the EOS 60D. Something with a 2/3 inch sensor gives me a great depth of field even at wider apertures. So if I use the maximum aperture in still mode, which is f8, I get tremendous depth of field, especially if I use the wider angle setting of this camera. So the smaller sensor does give you some advantages in this situation. Okay, let's have a look around the cemetery now and see if we can find some nice blooms of which I can take some pictures and show you the results. So in this first picture, I'm going to take the picture using the direct sunlight and then I'm going to use the diffuser to soften the light just to show you the difference between the direct sunlight and the diffuse light source. So the first picture I've taken at f4.5, I'm now just going to increase the depth of field by going up to f8. So the second shot was taken at f8 with ISO 160. I'm now going to use the diffuser to block the light of the sun but provide a very diffuse light source, trying to keep the diffuser as close to the plant as possible so you get the maximum effect of the light from the white nylon. So both of those shots were taken at f8 using the white nylon material. I'll take some other blooms using exactly the same procedure, using the direct sunlight first and then using the diffuse material second. Now I'm going to take some pictures of these daffodils. With the sun on the front, that's one nice effect, but if you go behind and get the backlight effect, so the sun is actually shining through the petals, you get a much more rewarding result. So here's the front shot, followed by the backlit shot. Normally we use the polarizing filter to enhance blue skies by adding some contrast, but in this situation we're going to use the polarizing filter to reduce the shine from leaves and flowers. So when using the circular polarizing filter, slowly rotate the filter until you eliminate the shine from the leaves, the cutoff point is quite critical. That's the cutoff point. Well, okay, that's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching. And as usual, if you don't already subscribe, please consider doing so, as you will be notified when I upload new videos. And if you do like the video, please give me the thumbs up and rate it. And I appreciate your comments and feedback. So once again, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in later videos. Bye for now.